Hey, I'm Jonathan Wild, and in this video, we cover how to use last in, first out for inventory costing under a perpetual inventory system. The last in, first out, or LIFO inventory method assumes that the latest or most recent inventory items purchased are the first to be sold. For example, let's say a company bought 3 identical units of inventory. 1 unit on June 2nd for $10, 1 unit on the 4th for $11, and 1 unit on the 25th for $15. On June 28th, we sold 1 unit for $21. Using LIFO, the last or most recent unit purchased, which was on June 25th for $15, is reported as cost of goods sold on the income statement. The other 2 remaining units for $10 and $11 get reported in inventory on the balance sheet. As you can see, under LIFO, the last or most recent unit purchased is sent to cost of goods sold on the income statement. The LIFO method can only be used when our inventory consists of identical items. For example, if we are selling identical gallons of milk, we could use the LIFO method. However, if we are selling like one-of-a-kind custom artwork, we would not use LIFO. Okay, let's do an example. Assume our records show that on May 1st, we had 20 units in beginning inventory that had cost $30 each. We fill that information into our table under beginning balance. On May 3rd, we purchased 30 units at $35 per unit. Now looking at our inventory balance, we see 20 units at $30 each from beginning inventory and 30 units at $35 each. On May 5th, we sold 35 units. Using last in, first out, or LIFO, we put the 30 units sold from the most recent purchase at $35 each and the next 5 units sold at a cost of $30 each in the cost of goods sold column. This leaves us with 15 units in inventory at $30 each. On May 11th, we purchased 5 units at $45 per unit. Now looking at our inventory balance, we see 15 units at $30 and 5 units at $45. On May 28th, we purchased 10 units at $48 per unit. Looking at our inventory balance, we see 15 units at $30, 5 units at $45, and 10 units at $48. On May 31st, we sold 25 units. Using last in, first out, or LIFO, we put the last 25 units purchased in cost of goods sold. So that includes 10 units at $48, 5 units at $45, and 10 units at $30. Looking at inventory, that leaves us with 5 units at $30 each. Last, we total our cost of goods sold to $2,205, which is reported on the income statement. We also see we have $150 left in inventory at the end of the month, and we report this on the balance sheet.